You will need our PoseCam app installed on your phone, currently available on the Apple Store. You will need the PoseAI LiveLink plugin for the Unreal Engine, available for free on the Unreal Marketplace. Our product page also has some useful links, like our GitHub pages. Here you will find the source files for our plugin. For complicated projects, sometimes Unreal works better when you just build the plugin yourself. For now, we assume you have it installed from the marketplace. You can find a demo project for UE5 on our GitHub page and Google Drive. Download the zip file, make sure to extract it on your machine, and then launch the project file. At startup, it may ask you about the Quixel Bridge. Just click Yes, Continue Without, as it is not needed. We use two files to get the PoseCam working. Let's first look at the third-person character blueprint. We have added the custom PoseAIMovement component to the character. This includes a lot of functionality and some helper nodes to get LiveLink working quickly. At the beginning of play, we create a LiveLink source at the next available port, starting count at 8080. You can also add a node which allows you to specify the port directly. At the end of play, we close the source. Otherwise, LiveLink sources persist in editor mode, and you could end up with multiple sources and no clear ownership of the animation. Importantly, this source and handshake replaces the use of Unreal's LiveLink menu and source edition. Whatever you put here will override the source in their menu, so you only need to use our nodes. The handshake allows you to configure our AI for your project. We will only focus on three settings for now: mode, rig, and mirror. See our website for details on the different modes, but you can use room or portrait for full body capture and use desktop for upper body capture at close range, like VTubing. Rig allows you to use several presets for common use skeletons. UE4 is the standard UE mannequin, MetaHuman is the UE5 mannequin, and of course MetaHuman rigs. Mixamo works on about half of their free rigs, and DAZ UE works on DAZ rigs exported to Unreal using the DAZ plugin. The mirror boolean tells the AI to swap left and right limbs and flip the avatar to look at the camera, as if you were looking at a mirror. Otherwise, the AI animates in third-person mode. The other important blueprint is the animation blueprint. We provide one already set up for the UE5 mannequin, but if you bring in a different skeleton, you will need to set a new one up. The anim graph feeds the LiveLink node into the final animation. The LiveLink node requires you to specify the name of the source for the animations. This can change as different users connect to the project, so we use a variable to provide the name. We also created a retarget asset which only uses joint rotations. This allows you to use LiveLink on different size skeletons without needing to specify the correct joint distances or bone lengths. The event graph fetches the third-person character, finds our PoseAI movement component, and gets the name of the current subject, which is needed to get the LiveLink node working. That's pretty much everything. If you hit play, you should see two characters on screen. We show their IP addresses and port numbers so you can easily connect the app. Go into our iPhone app, set up the address, and connect. Make sure you are on the same network and your firewall also allows incoming connections. You should be able to begin animating just like this. Good luck and happy posing.